All right, before you get on site, you need a Part 107 or trust certificate. You need to make sure your drone is registered. Go to faadronezone.faa.gov and register your drone. Download Before You Fly app on your phone so that when you get on location, you can tap into that app, make sure everything is okay from the weather to the authorizations you may or may not need to fly in that particular area, and anything else you need to know before you can safely take off. If it's unauthorized airspace, like me, with my luck, I'm constantly requested to fly on a Class C airspace, which is not an authorized airspace to fly in with your drone. So I either have to make a request on that specific location 24 hours prior, at least, or a better option, if you're able to do that, is to go through the DJI unlocking request. It's at dji.com/flysafe, and it's a custom unlock. So if you work for an organization or the government and you need a specific request for a longer period of time, a couple of years, in a very specific area, and you can explain why, you may be in luck, and then they unlock your DJI and you're able to fly in these areas. Now, you have to have a Part 107 and you have to be a safe pilot. You need to know that you are responsible and that you're not going to put anyone at risk. All right, so let's go through some drobo equipment needs. You need a few batteries. Batteries don't last very long, so in my bags I have 3 batteries. They're fully loaded, I'm ready to go. I have a large SD card. If you're going to fly and burn memory, you need to be prepared. I film in 4K and I try to film lengthy videos because I prefer to cut what I don't need in the editing room. So I recommend you get as large as possible the SD card so that you don't have to worry too much about it. You even may want to get a couple of SD cards with you so that when you're on site, you don't have to worry about it. All right, a super important thing that I think is really helpful is to have a hotspot so that you can have Wi-Fi connection. So what you do is when you get on site, you open your hotspot, you connect directly. This way you can update your software so that you know you're ready to fly. And if you need to connect to send any kind of forms to get an authorization to fly on the spot, you're good to go. Otherwise, you have to go back to your office or your house or whatever, do what you forgot to do, and it can be a nightmare. So get yourself a hotspot if you can. It will save you a ton of time and it will be a life savior. I much prefer getting an SD reader to upload. There are several things that you can purchase that make it very easy. Let's go over the flying basics. You have your authorization to fly at said location. It's done twice. You have your registration and certificate handy. You make sure your registration and your certificate are in your bag, because if the FAA or an officer comes and requests to see it, you will have to provide that information. Your drone clearly displays the registration number. You need to have it very clearly on the drone itself. So make sure you do that. You went over your pre-list. That's really important. When you pass your Part 107, it tells you that you should not rely on your memory. You need to go through your pre-list so that you don't forget anything and you are ready to fly. A couple of things: you want to make sure the rotors are not broken, and you also want to make sure you remove that cover. You do not want to fly with this because it will really mess up the quality of your photos and videos. So make sure your gimbal is free. This is important that you look into that before you have the drone in the air. And it's very easy. Now, you want to put that back when you're traveling. Even if you're just putting your drone in the bag, or if you're driving in your car, it's really keeping the gimbal safe. It's very fragile, so you want to make sure you don't mess with it. This keeps it together, but do not fly and film with it because it will create glare and it will really, really reduce the quality of your footage. You updated your Mavic Pro 4 app. Your drone is connected and ready to take off. You went to Before You Fly to watch the specs, And I'll do another video on that at some point. That's important that you get comfortable with before you fly. There's a lot of information in that app that really will help you determine if it's the right place to be, the right time to fly, and it gives you everything you need, so get used to it. Make sure home is safe. When you're ready to take off, your drone will choose that spot to be home. And if anything were to happen during the flight, you lose connection, battery down, or anything like that, your drone automatically comes home. So what you want to make sure is that there are no trees, no electric lines, no anything around, so that there is a clear space of a while so that your drone can safely come home. It will not necessarily be 100% specific, so you need to give it some space. You need to make sure your drone can come back and not hit anything. You don't want to be in the middle of the road where a car can be there. You don't know what could happen. You want to make sure that that home is safe, comfortable, and that your drone will be okay if it comes back. You want to make sure your battery is fully loaded. Again, batteries don't last very long, so make sure you have a few in hand, and make sure that the one that's in the drone is fully loaded. You do not want to leave your batteries plugged in at all times. It will kill them. I killed 3 batteries that way because they are automatically uncharging themselves. So if you keep them on, they uncharge, recharge, and die. What you need to do is know when you're going to fly, and a few hours before you go, you plug everything so that they're fully charged and you're ready to fly. When you come back to the office, you don't need to recharge your batteries. You just leave them be. You will only need to recharge them when you know you're going to fly in a couple of hours. Make sure you have a perfect line of sight. Once you have your drone in the air, you do not want to lose contact with your eyes. So don't put yourself in a location where there is a gigantic tree above you, or there is a building that will prevent you from seeing everything that you know you need to catch or film or take pictures of. You need to really think before you bring it in the air. You will have to make sure you have complete control of your drone, visually connected at all times. So keep that in mind. With all of this stuff, you're set. You're ready to go in the air and enjoy your flight. All right. You had a fantastic day, you were flying all day, you're coming back to your office, and you need to upload your footage. Get your SD card. Open your drone, get your SD card, that little petite thing here. Insert it in a docking station. So I'll show you a couple. There is this one that is very small and that I used for a while. I just purchased this one, which is much bigger. And you just insert the SD card into the station, and your computer reads it, you copy all your files into your drive, and you're good to go. Once you're done, you replace the SD card in the drone and you wipe the card so that you have a completely blank card, so you have all the space you need for your next shoot. And that concludes Drone 101. I hope that this gives you a couple of tips that may be helpful for your next flight. Have a beautiful day. Thank you again for coming back to Katya's Buzz. I hope you'll take a second to like this video and subscribe to my channel so you get more videos like this one. Talk to you soon. Have a beautiful rest of the day. Ciao, ciao, ciao. Thank you.